health, it's the last of those three. Talk to me about health. I mean, you briefly mentioned it before that health and money can be very much related. And obviously all of these are interrelated too. But when it comes to health and manifesting good or bad health, if you use that word, tell me how the secret applies to that.
Well, I think the really great thing about using the mind to help you with health is that you can do it at the same time as you might be following any medical procedures or whatever. And so it's something that can be done in conjunction. The mind has total control over the body, total control. So you can, with your mind, you can do anything. And we just have tens of thousands of stories that's evidence of that. And so I think it's important, like some people want to do alternative procedures, you know, go alternative routes, and then others want to do traditional. And I'm not here to tell anybody to change their path of what they're choosing. But what I will say is that if you use your mind for what you want, and you see what you want in your mind, your mind will completely instruct the body. The subconscious mind will instruct the body. The subconscious mind controls the body. So, and the way to the subconscious mind is through the conscious mind. So straight into the subconscious. And the thing is, we deserve health. I think, you know, any time that we have something that is a challenge in health is always like a message for us. And also to just watch our emotions. You know, I think like Louise Hay did this incredible book years and years ago about linking emotions to particular parts of the body, the thoughts, like anger, I think, was liver. And so she did this incredible link. That book is amazing. I mean, I have that book still. And, you know, if you get a cramp in your leg, she tells you what kind of thought, lackful thought that is linked to, and the way to reverse it. And what's her book called? It's her number one book, everybody. Anyway, it's her number one book. I think that is also amazing, and for the health of our body. Like I say this all of the time, is just think about what you want and think positively and feel good. Because your body deserves it, and our body is energy. And if we're contracting, we're stopping the flow of the energy in our body, which then causes all kinds of problems and disease and breakdown. And so just do everything you can to feel as good as you can, at peace with everything. Don't put boxing gloves on and try and battle the world and punch it into shape. Into the shape that we think it should be. Like people ask me all the time, the first question I want to ask you is, what do you think of everything that's going on in the world? You know, that's the first question people ask. And I just say, everything's on track. Everything's on track. And do everything you can to send really good energy into the world, you know. I mean, ever since the beginning of civilization, there's been, unfortunately, suffering, but there will be a future where there's no suffering. It's just a ways away.
Yeah, and I think you cite like the placebo effect as a great example of how powerful the mind is over the body. It's a funny one. There was a whole article, episode of 60 Minutes a few years back, where they talking to pharmaceutical companies, and they all have to acknowledge the placebo effect is massive in these trials. Mm-hmm. But then they kind of leave it at that. Then they move on and keep creating all these other things. But it's like, it can be sometimes, you know, 30 or 50% change, just the placebo effect. So it's kind of staring right in front of us that we have all this power over our body.
Yes.
It's not really addressed by Western medicine or medicine in general, is it?
It isn't, no. I mean, quantum physics has helped us a bit, you know, with the areas that it has broken into. But, you know, science, it's going to take a while for science to get there. And that's why it's important for people to know the power that they have and in terms of empowering thoughts. And so what thoughts do you want to empower? Do you want to empower thoughts of health and well-being despite what is happening? Or do you want to fall down into, you know, sickness? And I mean, we saw with the pandemic how terrifying that was for the world, you know, and that's just a whole lot of thoughts of what we didn't want. And it just terrified the world.
Yeah. Because if you think about what you don't want, your brain doesn't know the difference between that and that's what you do want. So just thinking about that will draw that energy to you. Yeah.
Yeah. Law of attraction does not know no. There's no negative. There's no absence. It's only creative. So it's creating all the time. What you want, what you don't want. What you want, what you don't want. What you want, what you don't want. So best to have it create what you want.